coming from the lower brackets, going to try and win. I'd heard them backstage claim they haven't lost on stage yet. Let's see if they can keep that up. It is FM Esports! And playing against them from outside the country, coming in from Spain all the way to try and win on our stage. Ladies and gentlemen, it is Existence! Good luck, guys. Good luck, guys. Gonna be some very exciting games coming up. And to take you through all these exciting games, you have your wonderful casters in the form of Kaidite and Chewy!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Coventry Rico Arena. It is myself, Chewy, and of course, joined alongside me is Kaidite. Today, we will be bringing you the final Existence going up against FM Esports, and man, what a grand final we've got ahead of us.
Yeah, definitely. It's going to be great. It's a best of five, and Existence coming through the upper bracket. They've got a 1-0 lead, but if FM win this first map, which will be Inferno, that could very quickly change.
Yeah, basically, if they win this first map, we'll have three maps remaining, and it basically then moves into a best of three format. But of course, as you said, because Team Existence have gone through those upper bracket stages and with almost relative ease, I'm just looking at the bracket now, they are yet to drop a map.
Yeah. They've got that one map. They haven't lost so far this weekend.
Yeah, exactly. And they did miss the group stages. They managed to qualify for this tournament through the online qualifiers. They've got free travel, free hotel, free team pass and everything. So they're having a whale of the time, and now they've got a one map advantage in the grand final of the tournament.
Yeah, and talking about map advantages and talking about maps, map number one will be Inferno, map number two will be Cash, map number three will be Mirage, and map number four will be a map that I don't really like, but I'm sure everyone else does. It's a map that I have a bit of a dislike against, but hey, it's Cobblestone.
Cobblestone's always an interesting one. I'm not the greatest fan. I swear I heard like a tiny bit of a sigh there from the crowd, actually.
I think they've improved Cobblestone a lot with the new Cobblestone. They've sort of turned back the years and made it a lot more similar to the old Cobblestone back in 1.6 and back in Source. And it's a lot more even as well. Because we think back, for example, in Cologne when they played Cobblestone then, it was very, very CT-sided, but now it's a lot more even, as we saw it played at Katowice a few weeks ago. But anyways, Chewy, you know what I'm going to ask you, don't you?
Predictions.
Yep.
In all honesty,
he knows me too well.
Yeah, of course. I just know this guy. We cast together almost too much, it seems, nowadays. But in terms of predictions for me, I think it's going to be a really difficult one for FM. Not only are they a map down already in this series, but they've already lost to Existence today, actually, in the tournament. I believe that was in the, upper bracket.
Yeah, and then FM ended up dropping down to the lower bracket.
Yeah, so it was the upper bracket final. FM lost that 2-0. So I have a feeling that Existence could take this one. What I would give to see it go all the way to the distance, I think we would be here all night into the early hours of the morning if it did go to map number seven. But hey-ho, anything can happen. It's always Counter-Strike. We always know that anything is possible on the day. So personally for me, I feel Existence is going to take this one. What about yourself?
I think Existence will take it overall as well. But FM, like Thatcher said, they've not lost yet on the stage.
Yeah.
And it was their first game of the day up against Existence early on, and they ended up losing in a best of three. They lost on Inferno, and I can't quite remember what the second map was. I believe it was Cash. I can't quite remember. But FM, they're one of those teams, even if we go back in the history books and look at previous I-Series with them playing as a side, it always takes them, especially on the second day of LAN, a few games, a bit of minutes to warm up and find their stride. So we can't count them out for this final just purely based on chain logic and what happened earlier on in the day.
And let's not forget, FM are also the team who have knocked out the number one seeds of Kick Esports. They've beat them, they've played them twice throughout this tournament, late last night, which myself and Hoss casted.
Yeah, and two best of threes.
Yeah, a 2-0 victory there. And then they played them in the consolidation final earlier on this afternoon, and that was a 2-0 victory as well. So FM Esports knocking out the number one seeds, Existence knocking out the number three seeds, I believe it was, in Team Infuse. So it's seed number two against seed number four, and we're almost ready to go on Inferno. All 10 players in the server, knife round one by FM Esports, and Kainat, I'm ready. Are you ready, good sir, for the grand final of the G2A.com Counter-Strike Challenge?
Chewy, I was born ready.
I'm sure you were, good friend.
Here we go. D-Inferno, slightly CT-sided map. Realistically, you expect the CTs to accumulate around 10 to 11 rounds. So, here we go. Pistol round coming out. And obviously, because when you're on the T-side, you're only really expected to get 4 or 5 rounds. If you manage to win the pistol and then take advantage of the next two rounds where you have the weapon advantage, then you can easily find yourself at 3 rounds.
Look at this stat coming in from FM Esports to start things off here. They've only got one single player on A, gambling a lot of their attention over towards the B-bomb site here to start things off. We are live straight away, not wasting any time. You can see on the map there all those 4 players. Only Socken, otherwise known as Falkies, in the game here. In pit, that usual position that we've been seeing him play all weekend. He has been doing a good job of it, but this is a big risk here from FM.
Well, it seems like FM have watched some Existence demos, they've done some of their homework, and they seem convinced that Existence are going to perhaps try and split this B-bomb site. We saw Neil Zeno looking towards CT spawn, expecting a few Spaniards making their way through Arch, and there's the opener from Weber, looking to make it a double. He will make it a double. And well, the crowd certainly enjoyed that one.
It's great to have an awesome crowd here at the esports stage at the Coventry Rico Arena. Weber gets his third, that's the hat trick. Will he get the fourth? Mason is going to try and respond. Is a Tech Knight going to take him out? It will, so no more for Weber, unfortunately, but now left in a 4v2.
Hey, FM, they've still got a 2-man advantage here. We've got Socken, who's quick to pounce on the rotation, and you know what? Existence also rotating, and they're going to run straight into Socken. The problem here is they've got that Tech 9. If they drop Socken, they might be able to go for a quick plant, but they're in fact heading towards Arch, and they've got Neil Zeno making his way in from Library. He gets nailed in the head, and now Socken holds off flipping. He's still got Mason to deal with. Mason is now dead. 1-0 FM.
1-0 FM, and the crowd cheers. Nice pistol round coming in from the British squad. I mean, you mentioned it earlier on, so did our lovely host, saying that FM haven't lost on this stage, and it's going to be really interesting to see how that plays in their favour as time goes on, whether the fact that they've played on this stage before, they're ready to go, they know what it's like on this stage, is going to be an interesting thing as we get into the game. But as expected here, Carnite, we see this time and time again now, that Tech 9 pistol and armour buy in the second round for the T's.
Well, the Tech 9, even after they nerfed it recently, it's still so goddamn powerful. I mean, you said it earlier, you can argue whether it's actually a disadvantage to the terrorists at times because of how good of a weapon it is, especially for the price and the fact that it's just a pistol.
Yeah.
So, standard stuff here from Existence. They brought up armor. Bar Carey, who is most likely going to be that player who's conserving a bit of cash because they perhaps want to pick up an AWP ASAP.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing how that AWP plays a role in this AWP match. It wasn't too common earlier on when watching the Kick versus FM game. FM really not deciding to use it too much on their T side, but out come the flashes and out come the grenades as Existence make their entrance onto the B-bomb site.
Yeah, towards the B-bomb site, the Spanish train goes. Socken sprays and prays through the smoke. There's the double, good stuff. But Musambani will still get the bomb down. They've still got the Tech 9s. You can't rule them out, especially up close and personal like that. Weber, such a key player for FM Esports going down, but hey, FM, they've still got the rifles, or have they? Musambani pushes with the Tech 9, and the Tech 9 by itself, you can practically argue, is like a rifle. It's all pressure on Mike S now. He's got to try and save the day. They're twisting and turning. Existence here, just running down the clock. Run down the clock, they will not. But Mike S, does he have a kit? He does not. He's got to run away, and it is going to be an Existence round.
Unfortunate there for Mike S and the FM Esports squad, but Existence instantly even up the situation here. And that was a shame. It was just really the Tech 9 coming in too strong. And that's the thing with this gun. Although it has been nerfed, although it has, you know, its long-range drop-off has been taken further back now, so it's more of a short-range weapon, it's still just as powerful at close range. And we saw it moving around there when Weber got taken out. It was just a one-tap straight to the head. Nothing FM could have done about it.
But when you've got those rifles, you cannot allow a player like Musambani off his leash to get 3 kills with just the Tech 9 like that. And now FM, let's see whether it's going to be a round that they live to regret, because now momentum shifts in favor of Existence.
Well, into round number 3 we go. Pistols on both teams here, as Carey is still deciding to stay with that Tech 9. And FM are forcing this up. I really don't blame them in this situation here, Kainite. They're not going to be happy that they lost that Antico in round number 2. So Mike S was able to save that M4. Not only that, he's also got that armor as well, and also the defuse kit, which could come into play if he's able to hold on for it for a while. But still, with just under a minute left on the clock, not too much going on, just trying to find out some information, our team Existence.
Yeah, it's an interesting setup coming in. Both Socken and Neil Zeno holding Arch. Neil Zeno obviously there with the flash, a lot will most likely happen. Nilzinho throw the flash down. Sokka will take the first hit, and he will get a hit onto the head of Kyrie. There's the pop flash from Nilzinho, and into his CZ they run. Gets one, but it's not going to be enough as the Spaniards still try to make their way around Arch here. Weber quick on the rotation. Let's see whether Existence wrap around the bomb site or head through CT spawn. They still have CTs waiting.
I mean,
this
is the thing, because Sokken has backed away from Arch, that allows the T's the advantage now to choose whether they want to wrap round A, as you mentioned, or go through CT spawn. But Lau is going to take down Sokken, so we're now left on a 3v3. Mike S responds, and it looks very crucial that he was able to save onto that M4 in the last round, as it's a 1v3. Musambani, with 6 seconds left on the clock, will plant the bomb, but Weber finishes him off. And FME Sports on the force buy win the third round.
That was actually really well played from Musambani, considering the situation he found himself in. 3v1, he's planted the bomb, he's lost the round, but that now guarantees an extra $800 on top of the cash that Existence would normally get for playing and losing that round come this next round. So look, they're force buying again. It's worked for them once and they're going for it again.
This is what we see more and more often now. When it's back and forth like this, when you see a team win a pistol round,
you want to keep pressure on your opponent.
Yeah, exactly. You don't want to give up. It's almost, you know, a war of a mental game of who's going to give up first and go for that full eco. Who's going to try and bring some of that pressure off? But I like it here. This is what we want in a grand final. We want constant pressures. Oop, that smoke grenade didn't exactly go to its intended area, but still, Existence trying to see what damage they can do with these Rec 9s. Weber will start things off.
Yeah, very passive setup coming here from the B bombsite from FM Esports. Mazen comes in, and that is the B bombsite open now for Flippin and Koba. He's playing here on the flank. Balkis, or Sokken rather, knows where he is. He's, of course, the Danish member of this FM side, but the bomb's down on B. Chewy, the CT still have to wait for the reinforcements to rotate in from Banana. And of course, the T's in this case, they've got time on their hands and they've got the positional advantage to play with.
And they've got grenades to work with as well here, as we see a Molotov going down just to try and delay that push from FME Sports even more so. Musambani now just over in New Box is going to get spotted. Will he get taken down? I'm not too sure, but Karnak, the clock is ticking. Down goes Nilzinho. Mason isn't going to be seen over there, so he gets another kill with a Galil. It's a 1v1, but there is no time left, and Existence responds straight back. Karnak, we are all even, 2-2, and that's a shame for FM. It looked like they had a good setup on that B bomb site, and I've been casting them today, and they've been looking strong over towards B. So for the second time in a row, well, second time in relative quick succession, we see Existence with those Tech Nines come in and reign supreme on that B bomb site.
Well, that round there was a great example of how, even though you're a man down, how much more the game turns in your favor when you've got the bomb down as a terrorist and you can get those great afterplant positions. You just hold the angles which you know the CTs are going to come from. Yep. You know that they're going to have ants in their pants, so that they're going to be hungry to try and move ASAP and defuse the bomb. And essentially, FM Esports just ran into the crosshair of Musambani and co. And here we go. It's tied at 2-2. And at the moment, the T's, it's a cheaper side for them. They've got more firepower. But again, FM Esports is a CT-sided map. So let's see whether they can make that work in their favor and whether we're going to see yet another round go back and forth between these two. It's been a great game so far.
Smoke grenades will rain down on that smaller B-bomb site as out go the Spaniards of Team Existence, making their presence known. They are not wasting any time here. The clock is ticking and they need to find these counter-terrorists and put them to sleep very quickly. The flash grenades are coming in and the rotation's coming in as well. Cryptics will get dropped, but Weber, he's been playing this position so well so far this tournament. He's not going to be able to do much more damage here though, as he's taken down. My guess with York will respond. And we're left in a 3v2.
Yeah, here Existence really struggling because the bomb was dropped. Flipping, however, with the Galil to add insult to injury to FME Sports. But hey, they've still got to try and pick up this bomb. The question at hand is Sokken aware of what's going on? He's only got a scout, he's got no armor, and Nilzinho, he's not even got a rifle. Mazen with the headshot, it's all down to the Scotsman. He will get Mazen in the face, but Existence still live to fight another day. But hey, that was a force buy from FME Sports. They didn't win the round, but they still dealt a heck of a load of damage onto this Existence side. You don't want to allow the T's to build up bank.
No, I think if Mike S and Weber had been able to do more damage with the rifles that they had, because we saw Weber had that M4 right in the back of the site. We also saw Mike S even using the AWP. And I think if they had been able to utilize them a bit more, like we've been seeing them do time and time again earlier on in this tournament, they could have stood a good chance of holding that beam bomb site. Wasn't the case, but have a look at this aggressive push here coming in from the CTs. They've only got pistols in hand, so they're changing up the tempo.
Yeah, for my liking, FM Esports, they've shown too much respect for Existence, particularly in and around the banana area.
Hello,
Sokken from underneath. He will say thank you very much. for this Galil, but Mazin, he spotted him. He's going to be calling that out to the rest of his teammates. Flipping with the headshot, but they are still a man down here. Chewie, make that two men down.
He's got the bomb.
Yep, yes, he does. And now Existence, they're in a tough situation. But again, they still have the firepower and the armor to get themselves out of it. But not if Weber has his say. Great stuff from FM.
This is just back and forth gameplay, exactly what we would have wanted in the grand final of the I-54. G2A.com Counter-Strike Challenge. Mason now making his way down second mid. Will smoke off the bomb as he tries to pick it up even just to get some cover. But he knows that there are angry CTs all around him. And I mean, kind of, this game is just back and forward. It almost seems like teams are standing more chance of winning a darn round with pistols in their hand than they are anything else. Mason will get the kill, but he's tagged down to 15. And with only 28 seconds left on the clock, we can still see Cryptics here just holding Banana.
Yeah, 22 approaching the 20-second mark. And to no surprise, Mazin is going to be heading towards the B bomb site. Three opponents. Chances are there's going to be two players on the larger bomb site and one player on the smaller bomb site. Cryptics, he knows there's barely any time on the clock. He knows that Mazin really there had to try and plant the bomb. And of course, he's not going to be able to.
The change of tempo works for FM Esports with only pistols and hardly anything else. I don't think they had armor or grenades really to work with there too much anyway. And it worked for them. They changed the pace. They caught Existence off guard. And they've punished Existence now as they will be on an eco themselves. It's going to be one P250 and one Tech9, but absolutely nothing else here. So finally Existence have given up on the mental game that it's been between these two squads in the past six rounds of just trying to force the other team down onto an eco. It's been back and forth the entire game so far.
Yeah, FM need to show no respect here towards Existence, particularly on the banana area. I'd like to see them smoke the bottom of it from CT spawn, push down. Do not allow Existence to push up to the top of Banana, because once they're there and you allow them to throw their smokes over to Coils and CT spawn, they will launch a B attack, which we've seen them do time and time again. Their A attack hasn't been too great so far, so let's see what they can pull out the bag here. They've only got pistols.
Well, have a look at this. We've got one player who's in CT spawn at the second, leaving Arch wide open. Nildinho will be covering it, but he's covering it from a distance. He's the man on your screen now, and he's going to be backing his way through towards Library. Flash goes out, but they've already made their way through CT spawn, and he's not aware of this. He's going to catch it late. So they've got full control of the CT spawn area. Nildinho, with a bit of unlucky timing there, he will get found by one player, and unfortunately GoTV takes us to the complete wrong bomb site, but Falkies, or Soccer, as he's better known, will find them starting to wrap back round now. And in all honesty, Kainar, I really would have liked to have seen Existence just completely push around CT spawn and seeing if they could get aggressive in that construction area and make their way onto the B bomb site.
Yeah, I agree, but I think they knew that because they pushed through Arch and they faced no resistance, they knew that there must have been someone hiding in Library, and that player was Nildinho, and they spotted him eventually.
Or that he could have been right on that B-bomb site, and they would have stacked three on B if there's nobody covering Arch whatsoever. Because I've seen FM do that. I've seen FM just playing two people in pit quad area earlier on in this tournament, and it has worked for them. I know it leaves Arch completely neglected, but somehow it worked for them a few times earlier on. I'm not too sure how successful it will be here, and they are evidently aware of that. But we're into round number eight. FM Esports just about clinching the lead in this game so far.
Mustambani with them hot flash and going towards Arch, but that ain't going to stop my guest Nielsinho and co. Three Spaniards hit the floor. Now it's all down to Mustambani and Flipping to try and save the day. Mustambani is now a dead man. And let's see what Flipping can do.
Last one left, Eye versus four. Counter-terrorist. What he's going to do is absolutely diddly squat. The answer to your question there, Kainai. As FM Esports advance their round win to two now. 5-3 is the score. Their money is sitting pretty, whilst on the Spanish side, it's not pretty whatsoever. About $2,000 average between all of them. And they're going to be able to get some P250s in hand. Not Tech9s, no armor buys, no grenades, just a couple of P250s. And Kainite, really, according to the script, this should be 6-3 to FM.
Yeah, and it's so important as well that FM Toxic have built up so much bank. I mean, they've got a player in Cryptics on over 9k cash, so that's a great start for them. But Weber comes in, granted up against the eco, but mowing Existence down, and let's see whether FM Esports can see out this round, because Mustambani here is in a great position to potentially flank, but that M4 of Sokken is just far too good.
Sokken has 15 frags already. We've only played 9 rounds, and Sokken is 15-5. Mm. Rolling in the money as well, as we see three FM players in 5 digits. We see Existence now buying what they can. They all have head armor. They've all got AK-47s, and they have got enough grenades here, Karnak. But unless they plant... I don't think they've planted the bomb in quite a while now. So unless they plant the bomb here, their economy, once again, could be in a dire situation.
Yeah, but it's so important, again, like I was saying, that FM have built up so much bank, because on the CT side, what can happen is, because it's so much expensive, you can... more than often, despite winning a good 3 or 4 rounds in a row, lose one on the trot, lose two on the trot, and before you know it, you're broke.
Yeah.
So it's really good that FM Esports here have a bit of leeway to work with, because Existence, I know that it looks like FM Esports are in the lead here, but Existence, technically, they're only 2 rounds away from hitting that magical number 5 rounds.
Yeah, exactly the
really
point.
Look for,
yeah,
on the T side,
I was
Inferno.
Going to make that exact point. We are only in round number 10, and Existence have already got 3 on the board. If they can get 5 or 6 rounds here on the T side of Inferno, they will be more than happy with that situation as the thing, as the game will switch over and the teams will swap in only a few rounds time. But 50 seconds left in this round number 10. No casualties as of yet. Both teams taking it slow. FM Esports holding strong with that 2 on B, 3 on A setup, the standard here on the CT side of Inferno. Cryptics will take down Kerry though, and that's the initial frag.
It is the initial frag, and not only has Cryptics got the frag, but he's gotten the information as well. They're preparing for what could potentially be a B push here. They put the smoke down to stop them. It's something that Existence did very well this morning.
Yeah.
They were very, very good at playing down the clock. And with only 20 seconds to go, FM here, they're putting the mollies out. And Existence, no, they have to rush through them because they need to try to get this bomb down. But Cryptics, he's got a hat trick so far. He's going to be hungry to make it 4. And let's see if he can find Musambani.
One thing that I have to say is quite ironic right now is the fact that, as I mentioned before, I've been casting FM Esports quite a lot this tournament. And especially on Dust 2, Neil Zinio shoots the chicken. They've been taking it so slow on their T side. And that's exactly what Existence did. So the problem for FM on their T side on Dust 2, which we saw a little earlier on, which actually isn't going to be played in this series, was that they took it so slow and kick their opponents earlier on, had grenades to use right up to the last second that they weren't able to push through. And we've seen that exact situation, but now in terms of FM Esports, having those Molotovs to use still with only 20 seconds left on the clock. So Existence have got to try and push through something because the clock is running down and they can't do it.
4 Galils, and that says a lot, really.
Not a pretty sign.
No, it emphasizes that Existence are low on cash. They could have potentially gone for AK-47s, but of course they value the helmets and they value the usage of grenades a lot more, particularly smokes. And when you see a lot of smokes, most of the time it suggests that you're planning on heading towards that B bomb site. Smoke off CT spawn, smoke off poles, but look at this. Sokken going aggressive. Again, this is the no respect style of play. I said FM need to put down on this game up against Existence. They can't allow Existence to get comfortable, particularly with FM on home soil.
And I think FM are aware that this could potentially be a B push, because have a look at the rotation. We've got Mike S, who's made his way over from the A bomb site all the way through into ruins at the second. Only 2 on A, but still, these 2 players that are on A, you would bank on them doing some great damage. They've been holding it down well so far. And I'm trying to think of the last time that we saw Existence get a bomb plant. It's been quite a while. So the defense so far from FM Esports has been very strong indeed. They looked good on Inferno earlier. They took 11 rounds on their CT side of this against the number 1 seeds.
And because FM went aggressive in second mid and they've gone aggressive in apps as well, they know that Existence must be at banana, which is why they've rotated the extra man towards B.
Yeah.
And now Existence, 15 seconds to go. They're not going to run into just 2 CTs, but 3 CTs. And that's a wonderful shot from Weber. Scream-esque headshot coming out. And I'll tell you what, the Spaniards, they're not going to get the bomb down this round either. They're falling like flies.
No time.
And they can't even find Lowell.
Well, Lowell was on the flank trying to go around through our arch area and then CT spawn to try and do some damage, but by the time he got in a great position to do some damage to FM Esports, the rest of his squad had disappeared off the map and he was the last one left alive. He will be able to salvage that Galil and save it, but the rest of his squad forced down to pistols. Carry with a Deagle, actually. You don't see that all too often. A couple of Tech-9s and a P250, but I said about how FM Esports against Kick earlier on today took 11 rounds on their CT side. They look very strong. Let's see what damage they can do. Mike S has been on form with this AWP, and once again showing what damage he can do with it. He gets the entry frag in round number 12.
Yeah, Carey gonna be the lurker. But Neil Zinio says, he puts his foot down in Apps and says, you know what, guys? Apps is mine. They're not gonna get control of it and rush into the B-bomb site. And here, just FM Esports doing what FM Esports do best, just mowing down Eniko. And it is gonna be 9-3 in favor of the Brits.
I really don't like calling out players for having a bad performance. It's not what I like to do as a caster. I don't think any caster likes to do that. But I'm just going to point out the two players on the existence side who are at the bottom of the scoreboard there for everybody
Lowell and Kyrie.
Who is watching. Yeah, Lowell and Kyrie. Not exactly what they would have wanted here. And they need to pick their game up now because the momentum is firmly running in favour of FM. And I'm just trying to count up how many rounds they've had in a row. I believe it's 7 they've knocked up in a row here. Oh, my guess.
Well, Mike S here taking no respect to a completely new level, which is great to see that the Brits have a heck of a load of confidence flowing through their veins. But Mazen, he wants to get revenge and lands the headshot onto Mike S. Question at hand is, are they going to salvage his AWP or stick around with this more versatile AK setup?
Well, the person who would be initially, in my opinion, the guy to pick up that AWP, especially when they had double up set up yesterday, would be Weber. But he's all the way on this B-bomb site, so he initially won't be picking it up. And I'm not too sure if any of the other FM Esports players would be confident picking it up themselves, but still, the bomb is over towards alt mid apps area. As we've got one player in Mason who's pushed right through over towards balcony. Musambani now making his way to second mid as it looks like things are going to switch up. We've got two players from FM on B, two on A, and with 40 seconds left on the clock, it looks like this is going to be an A take. And I've seen Neil Zinho hold this position all day, and he's looked very strong on it.
And this is why 4v4 actually favours the T's a lot more. The CT's cover less ground. That A bomb site is so large that it will be 4v2 on this rush. And out of apps they come. Socket with one, looking to make it a double. Yes, he will make it a double. 20 seconds on the clock. The bomb has been lost here, Chewy. And surely here, Existence can't pick the bomb up. They need to try and take out all these last remaining CTs.
Neil Zinho takes down one as now Musambani will be the last one left alive with only 8 seconds left on the clock. Cryptic through Arch will confirm double figures for FM Esports round number 10, and the economy for Existence is okay, but it's not great. Not what they would have wanted in round number 14. They're going to force this up, but Kyanite, they really need to look now at trying to get this to 10-5, because if it gets to 11-4, FM Esports are just going to have so much momentum. That being said, FM Esports against Kick, I know I keep mentioning it, but they finished the half 11-4. They were 14-7 up against Kick, and we went to overtime. Not only that, we went to double overtime on Inferno earlier on, so don't think it's over just yet, ladies and gentlemen.
So, can Existence get 10-5? Sokken, does he have other ideas? Well, he did, but he wasn't able to execute them. We've got 4 out of 5 Existence players in apps. Mike, hungry to return the frag, and return the frag he will. And here we go, Neil Zinho is just waiting there with the Molotov. If he sees any T's pushing through, he'll try to barbecue them and, of course, slow them down and run the clock down. And that's how simple the CT side is. But it's a lot easier said than done.
A lot easier said than done, of course. And us as casters can make it sound pretty simple, but maybe not the case. And have a look at this. Cryptics has got a lot of work to do. He's going to smoke that area off just to try and prevent Existence pushing through there. But they are slowly but surely creeping their way through. Weber's trying to hold Arch, but he needs to rotate back over to B because that's where the push is coming in. Cryptics is going to be calling down the radio for help as he spots the bomb. Lowell does get dropped, and now Weber through CT spawn is going to try and help them out. He picks up one kill. Mason and Flippin trying to do some work themselves, but kind of the clock is ticking. Weber will fall before Mike S with the AWP responds. And now Mason is going to be the last one left alive here. Unfortunately, we can't see what he's doing. We've got a slight glitch. There we go. We're back on board with the game. But Kyanite, even though Cryptics was the only player on that B-bomb site, a very quick rotation came in. Existence were too slow. And look at the clock.
Well, Existence were too slow. And pushing in, they pushed in one by one. And now Mazen's just going to try and get as many exits as possible. But again, yet another round, Chewies, where Existence have failed to plant the bomb. Yeah.
And look at their economy. I mean, again, it's okay, but okay isn't good enough. And as you can see on the screen, last round of the first half, we are into round number 15. And is this going to be an 11-4 half or a 12-3 half in favour of the Brits? The number 4 seeds coming in strong. They've not lost a map on this esports stage here at the Ricoh Arena yet. Are they going to continue on that fashion, or will we see the number 2 seeds, the team of Existence, who have not lost a map yet, bring this back into their favour? Sokken pushing aggressively, and it's paid off.
Has, but Mason may return it. He's been digged down to 9 points of health, but he's still alive, but they've still got a very angry Weber to deal with. Weber doing what Weber does best. 3 huge frags on this B-bomb site. And now Musambani with an AK-47, a bomb to plant, and a dream that won't come true. 12-3 at the half. What a half from FM Esports.
The crowd applauses, and rightly so, as the home squad of FM come in with a 9-round lead. Absolutely phenomenal work from them. And it's a shame because I've not actually casted Existence yet. You have this morning. They were evidently looking stronger than they have been now on this. What do you think is going wrong for them, Karnite?
Well, it looks like FM Esports are basically, you know, after losing on Inferno against Existence, they've almost taken a step back, reviewed the demo, analyzed where they think they went wrong, and gone from there. So, here we go. Let's see who's going to win this pistol round. Obviously, if you win the pistol round and you capitalize on the next round, you're expected to win 3 in a row.
Yeah.
Should FM Esports do that? Then the one has a match point.
Well, this
already.
Is the thing, expect to win the consecutive 2 rounds after that. We certainly didn't see that earlier on. Yes, it was just back and forward eco wins pretty much. And I keep seeing that at this event on Inferno. It's quite interesting, but I don't think we can really underestimate how important it is here for Team Existence to win their CT pistol, because otherwise they're going to be in trouble. They already are in trouble, and Carey's in trouble, not down to 14 points of health.
So, to be or not to be? It's currently the FM Esports question. And by the looks of things, they are going to be heading towards B rather than towards the A-bomb site. It's a no-brainer, really, at times, because your pistols are better up close and personal, and most of the time, there is one less CT on this smaller bomb site. Cryptix leads the charge. He will get an entry frag. Musambani now, he's got to fall back into ruins and wait for reinforcements here, but no, he's going to go aggressive, and he will kill Cryptix.
Well, the bomb's been planted, and Mason on the flank will take down Weber here. This is looking dangerous. He's been able to pick up that 5-7 by the looks of things, and Neil Dino's going to challenge him, just trying to waste time. But the bomb has been planted. Musambani moving around. Ooh, we'll find Mike S. And this is all going wrong here for FM Esports. Can Sokken save the day? 5 points of health. He has armor. But that grenade is going to come in. He will drop. And it should be a defuse. But I don't think they've got time, or do they? Is there one player on top?
Yeah, plenty.
Yeah, plenty of time indeed. I didn't see. I saw one player backing off. And for a second, I thought, oh gosh, has that retake gone wrong? But yeah, plenty of time indeed. And it was close, Kyanite, but Existence pick up a very important pistol.
Don't worry. The Breath 9s are going to come out from FM.
Oh, dear.
Or are they?
Or are they?
We see two.
Only two.
Okay, so it looks like instead of going out with the Breath 9 armor, they're going to save.
It's because they planted the bomb in that first round.
Yeah, of course. So they'll go. Yeah.
So they're looking for that third round early buy.
Exactly.
Simple stuff.
Chewy, PhD in Counter-Strike Global Offensive.
Thank you very much. If only that was such a thing.
Maybe 12-4.
Anyway, round number 17 it is. We've got a Pro 90 in the hands of Musambani, an MP9 on Carey. And it's almost as if with this buy, they're kind of expecting FM Esports not to bother for that full Tech 9 buy. It's almost as if Existence have probably had that communication saying, okay, they bought, they planted the bomb.
Well, the thing is, there isn't that much pressure on FM Esports to quickly
return
the round because of the huge difference in round. There's 8 rounds between the teams. So here we go. Kyrie with that new buff. Oh, MP9. And he will drop to Mazen as well, getting on the score sheet. Cryptix has other ideas, but it was a bit of a tough ask.
And of course, because he's using that MP9, he gets more money from it. SMG's giving you more money, apart from the P90, I do believe. But he gets more money from that just to help the economy of the CTs out that little bit more as Team Existence. Now make it 5 rounds on the board here, and this is what we suspected. This is exactly why FM Esports didn't decide to go for that Tech 9 armor buy in round number 17. It's because they were saving up to try and see what they could do here with the AK-47s and one Tech 9 in the hands of Sokken. So into round number 18 we go here, and going up against a couple of FAMASes and a P90, these AK-47s should reign supreme.
Should. But let's see what happens. The AK, of course, is a one-shot headshot weapon as opposed to the FAMAS. It's a lot more powerful as well. So here we go. Neil Zinho just watching the flank from Quad. How are FM going to try and split here? It's very, very passive from Existence, but that nade could deal a heck of a load of damage onto the Scotsman, and it deals damage onto Cryptix as well.
FM Esports have had really good takes on Quad so far today, so it's really not surprising me that they've smoked off Arch and they're making a lot of their presence known over towards Quad, and that Weber is the player down banana. This is standard from FM Esports on the T side of Inferno from this tournament, especially that Incendiary Grenade will go down just to try and prevent any pushes, but they're actually going to make their way out of Arch now, but they're stopped again from that Incendiary Grenade, and we can have a look at that. One player who's been able to get himself through to CT spawn is going to potentially be able to do a lot of damage, because we see now FM backing away, making their way down towards Banana, and if that one T player left alone in CT spawn goes through, it's going to be Sokken. There we go, and he's going to be able to pick up a rifle on top of that, Kyanite.
The main issue here, though, Musambani put his Molotov down onto Banana, and Lippin also has just put his down, but look, hello, Mazen is going to flank them from behind. He's going to try and burn them to death as well. And with 10 seconds to go, Mike S and Co. need to get a move on. They need to hurry up and try to plant this bomb. 5 seconds and counting. Flippin's hiding at the back of the bomb site, and the bomb will not go down. And Sokken is just going to try and get out there and save that weapon. Great hold from existence.
This is the danger.
And the Molotovs were so significant there at the top of Banar.
Again, this is the danger for FM. This was the danger on Dust 2 against Kick. We saw it on both of the times they played Kick on Dust 2 in this tournament. And it seems like it could come into fruition here on Inferno. FM take their T rounds so slow. And when they get the entry frags and they can plant the bomb, you know, in a snap time with only 10 seconds left, it works. But it's only worked a certain amount of times. It's not worked all too often for them, in all honesty. And it didn't work there. They were too slow. Existence had the grenade still in the bank at the end of the round to throw down and to stop the pushes. We saw Mason on that incredible flank through mid down Banana, and Existence pick up another round.
The reason they fell back to Banana is because they tried out A and realized how passive their opponents were playing. Yeah. But what actually happened was their opponents were playing incredibly passive, but their opponents, at least on A, had used up all the Molotovs.
Yeah, this is the thing, because we saw Kick playing really passive, two players in pit earlier on quad side of A bomb site, and FME Sports still pushed it. They still went in, and they got the kills a lot of the time. Here, for some reason, they decided to back away and go over towards B. I'm not too sure why, but it didn't work for them.
It's understandable why. The main issue, again, for them there was that Existence, the B players for Existence, were still left with those Molotovs and so forth, so it helped them slow it down. Because a lot of the time when you try to push the A bomb site, you try to see if you can find an entry frag, because you know you have to deal with the CTs. But talking about entry frags here, there so far aren't going to be any, or is there? Mazen with three, and Kyrie to get the final kill on this relatively simple anti-eco for Existence. But as far as FM Esports are concerned, they're yet to rack up a T round, so they really need to try and get their first one on the board ASAP.
Well, Existence lost every single round after round number 5 on the first half. Now they've won 4 in a row here on their CT half. It's 12-7. They've just got to take things one round at a time. We do see FME Sports with the buy here. They've got 5 AK-47s, so they can do some damage, of course, with these. Time and time again, we know what FME Sports can do on their T side, but Existence, you know, they're not out of this game yet. And this is what I said. Despite it being a 12-3 half, do not count the Spaniards out at any cost.
Lowell playing just behind that truck, the forest spot, as I like to call it, where we saw him play quite a lot at Cologne. Weber, as usual, he's sort of the lone ranger in this FM side. They let him push another side of the map by himself to catch off rotators, but the flash is coming in. Kyrie to try and take on the incoming Brits, but he's not going to get a frag just yet. Now he will. Kyrie with the AK kill. On to Sokken. Sokken's been such a great player for FM Esports, and now he's down for the count. Got to wait and see who's going to get the entries for FM here.
Switch over to Neil Zinho, trying to find that player at quad. Mason down to 7 single points of health, but there's also a player. What's great is that player who's playing Arch right near the back of the A site, he's also got a player supporting him over towards the CT spawn area, just making sure that FM Esports can't make their way aggressively through, potentially push through Arch towards CT spawn, or just wrap around that A bomb site. Weber's going to get Molotov'd out just as he tried to make his presence known over towards B. And look at the time, kind of, again, a very slow round from FM, and the clock is ticking. Mike S gets an entry frag, but they're making their way into B.
They are, and that was great because they faked the A push, and now if FM can get this kill onto Flippin and dodge the CT coming from CT spawn, they will plant, and now they're in a superb position to try and hold off the incoming CTs.
Yeah, and this is the thing, this is what I said. When it works for them, when they get these late pushes and they get the entry frags, it works for them. When they don't get those entry frags, it does not work for them. They've got too little time to do any damage, but they've been able to get themselves into some great afterplant positions in time.
Well, Sambani, 1v4. Just gonna fall back to ruins. And really here, FM Esports shouldn't really let him get away. And they won't let him get away. I said FM needed their first T round on the board to give him that little boost, give him a bit of momentum. And they've definitely got it here. 13-7. And if Existence lose one more, money is gonna be incredibly tight, and they most likely will find themselves on an eco, even though they won 3 in a row initially. It's just welcome to the more expensive CT side.
If you are just joining us here, welcome to the G2A.com Counter-Strike Challenge. We've certainly got a great game on our hands here. And we're only in the first map of the evening. Existence with that 1-0 lead because they did come through the upper bracket section. But if FM Esports even things up here, we will technically be in a best of 3 format still yet to go. A long way yet, Kainai, and I'm certainly enjoying the action that these two teams are putting up against each other. Exactly what you would want in a grand final of a tournament.
Three more rounds is all FM need. Tie things up at 1-1. Existence, of course, coming into this grand final through the upper bracket. Hence why they've got a 1-0 lead. And let's see what Kyrie and Co. can do. It's an interesting boost here to potentially... Oh, they failed the boost.
It's almost
there.
As bad as you and me when we play together. We fail that boost constantly, so I'm just glad it's not just us. But anyway, back on board with the game. Kyrie will fall to the hands of Socken.
Trying to scout out any CTs hiding in pit. Weber again playing this lurker role, and he will get the headshot onto Flippin, and he's going to know now that this B bomb site might potentially be open. But FM, they still have their heart set on A, and Mason goes big with a triple. And down also goes Neil Zinho, and Weber now. We've seen him clutch before. He's arguably one of the UK's best players. He's got 20 seconds on the clock to try and retrieve something from this round. Can he do it?
Well, he's fired off a bullet, so they're going to know exactly where he is. He's got to try and do something, and once again, Existence do have grenades to work with. A flash grenade comes right at his feet. Will now all peek out? He doesn't even really need to. There's 6 seconds left on the clock, but Weber will get taken down. Great hold there from Existence. Mason was their saving grace, holding down Quad in style, and despite having that slightly less powerful FAMAS in hand, he did a significant amount of damage, and he's going to punish the FM Esports side. Look at this, Kainai. They're going to try and even out their economy, but with a couple of players on low cash, it's just going to be Tech9s. Oh, and two AK-47s. Okay, so they decide to show me wrong.
Yeah, they're forcing it up. They're forcing it up. Obviously, the fact that it took them so long to force it up, they were obviously discussing it. It's a big decision from them. But you said it earlier on, Chewie, the Tech 9 or the Rec 9, as we call it in the CS community nowadays, is so good and is so cheap that a lot of the time you can use it to take out a CT, then pick up one of their M4s.
Yeah, definitely. Well, into round number 22 we go. FM Esports still three rounds away from evening up the series in a 1-1 situation. We've got the minimap up, so you can have a look. Wall of smoke will prevent Neil Zinho pushing through. Weber once again in his usual spot, just seeing what information he can find, lurking and trying to be an annoyance. Over towards Banana has got a smoke grenade in his face as well. And as usual, FME Sports taking things very, very slowly on their T side.
So by the looks of things, FME Sports, they know that there's no one playing close quad. They know there's no one playing close arch. The question at hand now is, are they going to try and wrap round to B? Because, of course, they've got Weber by himself on Banana. Or are they going to try and dedicate towards this A bomb site?
Well, they've got to make a decision, and they've got to make it soon.
Those AKs, of course, and let's see whether they can deal the damage with those clash kickoffs. Kyrie with the M4 failing to get a kill through the smoke. Weber's going to be the man to try and flash the CTs on this B bomb site. He's waiting for the call. The communication comes in, and now Socken to try and deal the damage, and deal the damage he does. He will pick up an M4, flipping spots one. Here's someone coming from behind. It's 2 versus 4. Make that 4 versus 1. And it was a good attempt from Mike F and Co., but they don't know he's sneaking from behind them.
Yeah, well, with only 2 seconds left on the clock, I doubt he's going to be able to do too much more. He has only got that Tech 9, and now Kerry will challenge him after the clock runs out,
still
obviously.
Still a good round, though, for FME.
Yeah, it still
was a good
round. I know
they brought up two AK-47s. They're going to have to full eco it now.
Yeah.
But that's the beauty of having a strong half. They've got breathing space to work with.
And one thing, again, is because they managed to drop off a couple of Existence players there, that means that they're going to have to rebuy. We all know that the CT side is more expensive, so although they have got a full buy here, and they've got grenades, and they've got defuse kits, and they've got those M4s in hand, their economy as it stands isn't too pretty. I doubt FM are going to be able to take this round, but Existence are not going to be wanting to lose too many players there, because then they're just going to have to keep rebuying those armors, those rifles, and everything else that's needed on the CT side.
I think one of the most interesting things is how passive both teams have actually played against each other, which is very unlike FM. And obviously, they're trying to adapt to the quality of opposition they're playing up against here. And they're just taking their time here in T-Spawn. They've only got pistols, in fact, 4 Glocks and a Tech 9. They've not even bothered buying up nades or armor. They're probably just utilizing this time to just discuss tactics and stuff in spawn.
Yeah, well, I saw them do this earlier on again against Kick, and they actually left the bomb in T-Spawn and pretty much just ran down mid expecting Kick Esports to take them out in quick fashion, and they did. So they're not deciding to do that here against Team Existence. They're going to try and take some rifles off, but Socken will get dropped with that Tech 9, and with 40 seconds left on the clock, you can tell, yeah, they're definitely just discussing tactics, seeing what they can change up here, because the momentum is slowly starting to switch here, Kyanite. It was a 12-3 half, and now we're going to find a 13-10 scoreline.
I think one thing I'd like to see FM do is go for a full throttle, gas on the pedal take of the beat bomb site. Because Weber, they've always allowed Weber to push to the top of Banana.
Yeah.
Push a few men up to the top of Banana. Try and, for example, fake a push, force the Molotovs and defensive smokes out from existence early on in the round, so that once you know they've used up those nades, you still have a good 30, 35 seconds to actually try and execute your push using smokes onto coils, smokes onto the middle of the bomb site like Fountain, and smokes to block off CT spawn, rather than try and do that with only 20 seconds to go, because that's when it becomes really, really fishy.
Well, we saw when they changed pace on the CT side and they pushed aggressively down mid with the pistols, it worked, and they won quite a convincing eco round, so maybe changing up the pace here would work for FM. We will see what they decide to do, though, as it looks like in round number 24, they're just going to take it easy. But I'm liking this from Existence, actually, because have a look at those two players who are playing towards B. They're getting aggressive on Banana.
Yeah, this is the problem, though, because FM don't really have anyone watching behind bar the player at each step, so they've got to be careful that Existence don't get too hungry. And the question at hand here is, should FM Esports decide to fall back to Banana, which looks like they could be doing? Are they actually aware that Existence, for the first time, have pushed so far down Banana? He could take them by surprise, this Existence player, and this round could end up being a catastrophe for them.
Well, Existence have still got three Molotovs to play with here, so they can try and slow things down. But Carey up the top is going to find them. He misses his shots. Eventually, he's able to take down Mike S. But they're aware of that player up there now. Neil Zeno's going to smoke off Arch. Is he going to peek out? No, he's just seeing if Carey is still lurking up the top there on quad side. But he's actually backed onto the side. It doesn't matter, though, because he's just creating attention over towards A, because the bomb's going in towards B. Flippin's been holding this down well, and he's holding it down again here. Cryptix is going to try and respond, and he will do. Knocked down to 12 single points of health. But we're left in a 2-versus-3 situation here. This is going to be a really difficult one, I have to say, for the FM squad.
Yeah, I think the T here is going to try and get the bomb bomb, but no, he's going to fall down himself. And Neil Zeno now, with only 5 seconds to go, he's got the bomb. He's going to try and go for the save plant. Surely Kyrie won't let him have it, and he won't. And financially here, it's incredibly tight for FM Esports. And just like that, Existence, after going into the second half 12-3 down, the game is back now almost even Steven.
This is one of the things, again, I know I pointed it out a little earlier on, but this is why I said, despite the fact that FM Esports have got such a strong CT side, they've been letting themselves down on the T side. In the overtime, well, in the second overtime earlier on against Kick, they won 5 rounds on their CT side and then lost 3 on their T round before they were finally able to take the game out and finish things off. But just because FM Esports had 12 rounds and were 4 rounds away from taking this map on Inferno doesn't mean their Existence were out of it by any chance. FM need to change things up on the T side, and they need to do it soon.
Ooh, that Molotov is dealing the damage. We're going to have barbecued Neil at the end of this round. Cryptix gets one, however, picks up an M4, but he is no more. Kyrie comes in and will drop the final FM Esports player to 13-12. And now FM, they're going to buy up now. Be interesting to see whether they opt to go for an AWP player. But even though Mike S is their normal AWPer, we actually saw Mike S AWP a fair bit on the T side of Inferno earlier on in the tournament. But this time round, they've obviously opted not to go for that approach.
No, he's not been using it pretty much whatsoever from what I've seen on the T side of Inferno. I mean, there was a time when there was a dropped AWP from Fox from Kick, and they just stared at it and didn't pick it up on their T side because they are just more comfortable with the AKs.
I think it probably comes down to the quality of opposition. Kick and Existence, obviously Kick was seeded first. Obviously they don't want to take that gamble, but up against the lower teams, Mike S definitely tried to utilize the AWP, but talking about utilizing weapons, Weber is very good at doing that, and so are Mike S and Cryptix. It's advantage to FM Esports now. Bomb going down here on this larger A bomb site, and Flippin and Musambani, let's see if they can do it.
Well, this is what I said, that FM Esports had great success on the quad side of the A bomb site, and look at where they pushed, and look at how they've got the bomb down on the quad side of the FA and on the A bomb site. So Flippin and Musambani against the world here to see what damage they can do. Neil Dino is going to push through Boiler and takes down Flippin. Musambani's just got to try and save that M4 now, and that's exactly his plan. He will back away. We can see that those T players are going to try and back away now. Three of them are low, so they've got to try and hold on to those AK-47s. So they exit out of the A bomb site. Musambani looking for any exit frags to see if he can find anybody. Cryptix actually dies there. He was on 3 HP, but he's got to buy that AK-47 once again. Mike S has got to buy once again as well. They have got the money for it. But Existence have got quite a lot of money in the bank as well.
It was a really, really good execution from FM Esports, though. And the thing is, the fact that they broke through, they've now found a weakness in this Existence defense. Yeah. They were stood at second mid, they smoked off Pit, and that allowed one person to push through apps and then the rest to push around quad, yeah. And they smoked off Arch as well.
And they've been doing that time and time again. Round number 27 it is. And Karnai, do you think FM can close this one out?
Well, I hope so. No, I'm just kidding.
Regardless
of who wins this map, it's been a great map to not just watch, but also cast. But here we go. See, here we go. They're going to try and do the same thing again. They noticed there was a weakness in the Pit and Quad players, and they're going to try and take advantage of that weakness yet again. If FM are so hungry to get that all-important 15th match point, but the question at hand is, are the Spaniards going to make as many mistakes as they did in the last round? Have they learned from their mistakes? They've got a great dynamic defense going on. Let's see how they're going to change it around. They're playing even more passive this time round. Normally we see Lowell play quite up close and personal on quad. They've dropped both players back into Pit now.
Clock is ticking, 40 seconds left, and FM Esports need to make that decision to move soon. We can actually see that we've got one player on the B-bomb site, who's rotated his way through CT Sport, but now he's making his way back towards B, but they're gonna have to rotate once again. Maiden in a crucial spot here, he's gonna get spotted out, the team kill comes in, this has not gone well whatsoever for FM. Weber, the last one left alive, he will get shut down in Existence with a good hold. You said, would they be able to correct their mistakes from round number 26? They did so, they stopped that push, helped by a team kill as well. An Existence now one round away from evening up this game.
This time round though, we didn't see the smoke that landed right in front of Truck like we saw not the last round, the round before.
True.
And that obviously allowed that player who's hiding in the forest truck spot to just get a few easy headshots. And yeah. He was a player who turned around and killed yet another person coming from apps. And of course, the team kill didn't really help FM Esports' case to try and take over that bomb site. But Rek9's out, Mike S with armor, Sokken and Nielsinho with armor and helmets. And of course, they've got two flashbangs each, so that's four flashbangs altogether, and two smoke grenades. So we're probably gonna see just a simple smoke onto Coils, smoke onto CT spawn, try and get up close and personal with the CTs, force these Molotovs out first, and see what we can do once we rush into the bomb site.
Well, the CTs will have heard those Tech-9s come down, and they've still got more than enough grenades to try and deal with this attack coming in from FM Esports, but all the same, the clock is ticking once again, and FM are looking to set up for this B-bomb site push. Can they do it? They're going to push through straight away, despite a second smoke grenade coming down. They were just waiting for that first one to go, as Mike S gets one frag. Flipping will respond. He's been holding down B with great success so far. He will get the hat trick here, as now Sokken in ruins is the last one left alive. He's only got that Tech-9 to deal damage with. And they know exactly where he is. He will fall, and Kainite from a 12-3 situation in favor of the British. We are all even, 14-14.
Well, what we've seen so far is two world-class CT sides here on the Inferno.
Oh, most definitely.
And obviously, bear in mind, guys, the prize pool is £10,000, which is around $15,000. And I believe first place get around $7,500, and second place get half of that. So there's a big difference between finishing first and second. And if there's anything we know about FM Esports iSeries, they hate finishing second. They always want to be the top team, particularly as far as CS goes concerned. But here we go, Existence hungry to get match point. And financially, it looks tough for FM Esports. They're taking it very slow here at the bottom of Banana. No execution just yet. Neil perhaps the player to try and fake an A take. But if there's anything we've learned so far, Chewie, is that Existence, they're so good at holding that B bomb site. Most of the time, they're just flipping in there by himself, and he just sprays and prays and kills three or four incoming players.
It's crunch time on Inferno, ladies and gentlemen. Round number 29. We're either going to see a 16-14 scoreline, or we will be going to overtime here on Inferno. And I don't think I've actually casted an Inferno yet this weekend that hasn't been an overtime. But it's great to see. I love Inferno. We went 26-23 earlier on for FM Esports on this map, so they've got the potential to take this one still, but they've only picked up two rounds on their T side. That isn't good enough. Weber's going to start things off, though. Down goes Flipping, that man that you pointed out as holding down B so well.
Yep, but Musambani and Kairi quick to return those frags. FM Esports one man down, but it's quickly evened things out. The one-for-one trade, but Cryptic's here. He's surely on the phone to a medic. Only 5 points of health, and Sokken only on 23. A few nades here could do wonders for Existence, but unfortunately they've not got any, and now FM, they need to stay cool, calm and collected, try and hold these angles, hold these positions, protect the bomb from being defused, and down goes Mike S, and the defuse will well and truly occur, and Existence, they've got match point.
I predicted that Existence would be able to take this entire tournament after their performance that we've been seeing them do online. They look great in the I-54 qualifiers. They've been beating Kick online. They are one of those teams that can just come into these events and do damage. Flipping, that player that you pointed out, is probably one of the best players in the Spanish scene. And he's one of those players who can just do some great damage when needed. He can pick up a lot of frags. He can pick up the crucial frags. And Existence with 12-3 down, let's not forget Kana. I know we keep pointing it out, but it's a very important point to make. And Existence have had virtually a flawless CT side, only dropping two rounds.
15-14, this is the round it all comes down to. FM lose this one, it will be 2-0 to the Spaniards. FM win this one, and ladies and gents, we'll be going to overtime, and those are two huge frags for Existence. FM now, two men to the bad, and it looks like the bomb's heading towards B, but this is still incredibly tough. They're outnumbered, but not if Neil Zeno has his say. 3 versus 4, this is doable for FM, especially if they push the B bomb site here, where there's only one Spaniard hiding.
4 versus 3 with 50 seconds left on the clock. I think Neil Zeno may have just spotted that player on pit. I'm not too sure. It is Lowell playing his usual spot. Oh, gosh, very close to having an AK-47 meet him in the skull. And this is just so slow from FM Esports. This isn't quick enough for them, and they have been able to take down Flipping, so they will be able to make that entrance. Now, this is looking good here. They've been able to get full control of the B bomb site. They've also got control of Arch, and suddenly things have switched in their favor. It's all going to be left up to Carey and Lowell, but could that be an important frag here? It's left on a 2 versus 2.
Yeah, that frag there could have made or could potentially made or broke the round for FM Esports, but hey, they've got the bomb down now, FM Esports. They've got these angles to hold from. They literally just need to wait for Existence to just run into their crosshair. But again, easier said than done as Kyrie and Lowell make their way into this bomb site. Cryptix has been terminated. Kyrie will not be able to stop Weber, but he runs out of ammo. And Existence 12-3 down at half time. They're going to win the map 16-14 here on the Inferno. And that will leave things at 2-0 in favor of Existence.
Mason dropped 32 frags and only died 19 times. Absolutely phenomenal performance from the Spaniards. You can see why they are yet to drop a map in this entire tournament. They didn't play the group stages on Friday because they won the I-54 online qualifier, which you and myself casted. They've come through all the way and they started in the upper bracket yesterday. They didn't lose a single map. They've already played FM this morning, didn't lose a map against them here. And they were only 4 rounds away from losing and making this an even situation 1-1. And they still come back. And FM, 2 rounds on your T side of Inferno, that's not good enough.
Most importantly, though, in Counter-Strike, you've got to be a good, strong physical player, good player, but also you've got to be mentally strong well. Existence, it looked like they were down and out. If they had literally 4 rounds to lose those 4 rounds, that's it. It's 1-1 all of a sudden, and it's a BO3.
They didn't have
and guess
much
what?
To
they
play
didn't
with.
Let their heads drop. Yeah. And they fought and fought and fought, and they pushed, they huffed and huffed and puffed. And they won it in the end, and now they've got a nice 2-0 cushion.
Well, that's the first round that FM Esports has lost on the Esports stage here. We will see if this is going to be a 3-0 shutout here in favor of the Existence squad from Spain, or whether the British side of FM Esports can fight back. We will be going to Cash, I believe, is the second map in just a few minutes' time. But a quick advert break, guys. Don't go anywhere. We will be right back with the next map here from the i54g2a.com Counter-Strike Challenge. Well, apparently we are live.
We're live, okay. Hello, everyone.
No word whatsoever for production, but we are live. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Shout out to Alan in our ears for actually being able to tell us that and making sure that we know that we are live. Alan!
Alan! Go on, everyone cheer for Alan. Come on.
Alan is a legend. He's been doing a good job so far. We love Alan. Anyway, it seems that we are live, Kainai. Welcome back, good sir.
Okay, yeah. Cash, map number 2. Of course, map number 3, technically, of this best of 5. Existence came through the upper bracket. They had a 1-0 lead. And Inferno was the first map.
Yeah.
FM Esports went into the second half 12-3 up into their T side, and they ended up losing the map 16-14. Oh, they only managed to accumulate two T routes.
Not good enough, and they will not be happy with that whatsoever. But we are live here with Cash. Will this be the last map of the G2A.com Counter-Strike Global Offensive Challenge here at the Coventry Rico Arena at Insomnia 54? Or well, will FM Esports, dearie me, it's getting late. Hold on.
Look how aggressive Carey has gotten. Great USP kill from him. He knows that Cryptic is hot on his tail and Cryptic's quick to return the trade. And now Existence, are they going to rotate more men towards B? Or are they going to... interesting comment there from Socken in the chat that I'm sure guys on the stream can see. But anyways, over to you, Chewy.
Well, it's a 4v4, and of course this does favour the T side of FM for the fact that those CTs have got to split themselves up. Two on B, two on A. So they're going to make their presence known over towards A. Down go the Molotov grenades as FM Esports make their entrance.
Yeah, great volley to push out the players hiding in and around MBK. There's two there, but Cryptic's, surprise, surprise, he's the one who's mopping out the Spaniards, but it's 2v2. FM Esports, they've got full control, roughly, of this A bomb site, but Flippin's flanking them. They've got to be careful here.
And they've got to, well, they've had it long enough to try and get that bomb down, and they weren't able to do so, so they've not got the bomb down. Flippin on the flank will take down Neil Zinio and Cryptic's in quick succession. And that's the first round on the board for Existence. Not the start that FM will have wanted. It was technically a 4v2 situation because there were only two players on A. They made their entrance, and they were trying to get the bomb down, but they weren't able to do so. The quick rotation came in from the following two players who were originally on B for Existence, and FM lose the round.
It's credit where it's due for that Existence player who's going back towards short. Yeah. He didn't die, and he kept the pressure on the FM players. But here we go, Rek9's out. Mazen with the Pro 90, he gets one, looking to make it three. Mazen so close to getting four, and he will get four. Pro 90 spray kills up against the eco of FM.
Mazen dropped 32 frags on that Inferno map, and he's already got five here. I know he has been using that Pro 19, but still, he's one of those players for Existence who can do great damage. You've casted them earlier on. I haven't casted them yet this tournament. How was his performance against FM earlier on this morning?
He was good. All the Existence players played phenomenally well against FM Esports earlier on. Yeah. FM Esports, in fact, even though they lost the first map, they looked like a completely different FM Esports to the FM Esports we saw against Existence earlier on. But only Glocks in hand here. Can't really expect FM to get anything out of this round. If they get a few kills, that'll just be a bonus for them. If they pick up a weapon, that'll be nice for them too. But with just Glocks, it's difficult. I think in the last round, maybe if they had sent one or two people through the door area onto that A-bomb site, it may have helped them perhaps get a few extra frags to help them accumulate a little bit more cash. But here we go, 3-0. And this is where FM are going to really be tested. We've got AKs out, we've got an AWP out. Mike S most likely going to get boosted onto boost to try and get an opening at mid with it.
It's going to be an AWP in the hands of Carey as well on the Spanish Existence side. It's going to be an important round for FM to try and take, or at least get the bomb down just to help their economy, of course, because if they lose this one and don't get the bomb down, they could be back to pistols pretty darn snappish, which is not what they want. They are on the less favoured T side of Cash here. So kind of, again, just talking about that map a bit, we know that on Inferno, they were aiming to try and get five or six rounds really when Existence was starting on the T side. But for FM here on the T side of Cash, how many rounds should they be aiming for?
On the T side? Well, really, it depends on the teams. And yeah, there's the entry frag here. Cash is a very, very evenly sided map. It's not unusual to see it finish 8-7 in favor of either side. Sometimes 9-6 is a very common scoreline. But at the moment, Existence just having the time of their lives. Headshot coming in from Flippin. And let's see whether Cryptic can get an opening. He can with this big green gun, but they still need yet another one. And mid-control on a map like Cash, so important because it gives you extra gateways into both bomb sites, towards B through vents and through CT spawn, and towards A by making your way through short. But Mazen, he's still got that P90. And my God, is he putting it to good work.
Well, he swapped it out now, and the AK-47 will be his weapon of choice as Neil Dino pushes around the right-hand side of that smoke, just holding the angle to see what he can find. He smokes off short here with 24 seconds left on the clock. It's another slow push from FM Esports. Are they going to get shut down? Musambani takes down Neil Dino. Cryptic's now left alive in a 1v3. Can he get a 1v4 clutch in total? But he's got 12 seconds left to play with. All the CTs are surrounding, well, two CTs are surrounding this, and it looks like one player is actually going to try and go on the flank to spot him with that, you know, with that ult. They do not want him to keep this, and he's not going to be able to keep this. The clock runs down. He will be dropped. FM Esports lose their fourth round on a row. The money isn't great. They're going to try and go for a Tech 9 buy here, but, you know, we talked about what FM should try and really be looking for on the T side of cash. I think one thing that we've definitely discovered from what we saw earlier on is that Existence are a very strong CT team. They were on Inferno anyway. So if that carries on here into cash, and Existence are a great CT team on cash as well, I think FM will probably be looking to try and get five rounds here. If they can get six, they'll be in good stead.
Yeah, let's bear in mind, if FM lose this map, then they lose the grand final.
Yeah,
they'll
lose
it 3-0. That'll be it for them. And I think it was interesting, the last round that Existence obviously opted not to pick up that AWP that Cryptix had. So it tells us a lot about how they want to set up come the next few rounds. But at the moment, yet again, another anti-Yiko. And Tech 9 is going to come into good work, but hopefully, surely Mike Essen is going to be able to pull this one out of the bag. Smoke going in, he doesn't have the bomb, it's tough, he's surrounded from all angles. If he gets his frag, which he will, this suddenly might be on the cards for the Dutchman. But again, this is what went wrong on the pistol round. They're not checking that main area for the flank, and it's Flippin who's in fact the B player who keeps flanking round through T-spawn, and that's the second time that in Existence have done that now. 5-0. But the fact that it was just an eco round for FM Esports and that they dropped 4 out of 5 CTs does them a world of good.
Well, it's 5-0 on the scoreboard in rounds overall, and it's 5-0 for Flippin. He's not died yet and got 5 kills. So this is a great start for the Spanish team, who are yet to drop a map at I-54, showing why they are the second seeds in this tournament, showing why they deserve not to go in that group stages and only play in the upper bracket stages. They've been one phenomenal team to come to this tournament, I don't know what I'm saying, but here we go. This is better from Weber. That's what they needed.
Yeah, that certainly is what they needed. If there's any player who can really step things up and work his magic here for FM to try and unlock this Existence defense, it's none other than arguably one of the most experienced players on this side in Weber, the X-Nexus man, of course. So let's see what he can pull out the bag. Catastrophic for Existence. The name drops at the feet of Kyrie. And you know what, Chewie? They've decided, look, we're too low on HP now. Let's just fall back and try and save these weapons.
Quite interesting that a grenade thrown by your own teammate is the deciding factor on whether you go for a retake.
Look, it goes to show that we're all human, you know.
Yes. Well, still, Mason just looking for some exit flags. He will find one, he will find two. Actually, a sock and falls, just trying to hurt that economy for the FM Esports squad. They get tagged up by the bomb exploding, but they will not fall. All three players left for Existence low, but the crowd collapsed as FM Esports get their first round on the board. And let's see if the British squad can bring this back in their favour. Come on, Karnite. They're only 11 rounds away. I know that seems like a distance, but Existence, we saw what damage they could do. They took so many rounds on their CT side of Inferno, it just seemed like it came out of nowhere. So this could be over very, very quickly if FM don't step up their game and keep this momentum now going.
So Neil Xenia with that mid smoke. And at the moment, FM Esports just trying to sniff out where these CTs are hiding. They're playing pretty mid and B heavy. They've got two players playing the B bomb site and only one player on the A bomb site, who was in fact Maiden, and he is now down. So now Existence have to adapt. They need to rotate Masanbani from being that second player at mid to hold the A bomb site, and they need to rotate one person out of B, which is exactly what they've done.
Well, it's a really important frag to take down Mason as well, one of the standout players for Existence, the guy who dropped over 30 frags on Inferno. To get the entry frag on him here in round number 7 is very important. We can see Kerry single-handedly holding the B-bomb site down with that AWP in hand. But all the attention will go over towards that larger A-bomb site.
If they get their smokes correct here and execute with a great set piece onto A, they've essentially, if they cut off short and cut off truck, they've only got one CT to deal with come the next 10 seconds. So they should be able to drop Masanbani because they outnumber him and get the bomb down. But let's see how they do with their smokes.
Taking their time, but now they're going to push through and they're making it very obvious about what's going to happen. So the quick rotation is coming in, and what looked like only one player on the A bomb site has now been to three. FM are getting shut out of the bomb site. The clock is ticking, it's going down. We can see Masanbani in a great spot on quad will get the first kill. He will get the second because nobody checks it. He will get the third indeed as all of FM drop. Weber finds himself the last one left alive, and Kyanite, that really should have been an FM Esports take on A, but Existence saw those grenades coming in, and just in the quick flash of an eye, they were on A and they shut them down.
It was actually a really good smoke just near Forklift to block off any potential CTs peeking from short and any potential CTs peeking from truck. It was just a shame that after that smoke went off, obviously the smoke went off, and because there was barely any time left, Existence knew it had to be a dedication towards that A-bomb site, hence why they rotated over from mid so fast. And that's actually one of the perks on Cache. It's so easy and so fast to rotate between that A-bomb site and mid. And Existence, they were too fast for FM Esports, or rather FM Esports were just too slow to attack.
Existence have been looking so good on their CT side. Well, I'll just cast this actually very quickly as Flipping picks up one. He's pushed out aggressively, he will get traded out there. Musambani now looking for the frags. It will be a 4v2. But my question to you here, Kyanite, is that Existence, from what we've seen so far, have had a really great dynamic defense. They've been able to switch between bomb sites with relative ease and adapt to their situation. And because FM Esports seem to be taking their T side so slow and pushing with only 20, 30 seconds left to go, and it's very obvious when those smokes come out that it is going to be a push and not a fake, do you think that that's something which Existence is just playing off and enjoying, because it's obvious that FM Esports aren't going to fake anything now?
Well, FM Esports, I think there's no doubt about the fact that they need to change something. And I think changing up the tempo, simply based off of what we've seen so far, could honestly help them. Yeah. Even that round where they bought up armor and just Tech Nines, they were sort of just running out towards that B-bomb site one by one. You know, when you've got the Tech Nines, you want to get up close and personal, you want to be moving fast, a little bit more like this, and Weber reaping the rewards here. He might get another frag onto Musambani, but no, they're going to line up for him on this eco round. Nade will go towards Checkers.
Ooh.
And, well, this is just a bog standard anti-eco coming out from Existence in the end. However, they got more frags that round than they did in the last round, where they invested more heavier. And again, it was due to the upping of the tempo, getting utilizing the Tech Nines, what the Tech Nines are good at doing. And FM need to change things around now.
Existence halfway to victory on this map, and almost at the stages of victory. Here at I-54, they've been one phenomenal team. But FM Esports, for the British side of things, still trying to keep their hopes alive. They will certainly not give up easily, I can guarantee you that.
So Musambani, look, he's allowed him. Oh, that's a lovely Molotov going out, but it's not going to deal any damage to him. In fact, the Spaniard, only 1 point of health was what that Molotov did to him. But the fact that he's pushed all the way, or rather he had pushed all the way down towards the bottom of mid, that obviously cut off that area from FM Esports, and in order for him to potentially take him out, they've got a flash out, and that could have even given him an entry towards Vents, which could have been problematic should a B push occur and the T's run in towards Checker Room. So again, very, very slow from FM Esports, almost like they're waiting for Existence to make a mistake, go a little bit too aggressive. Yeah. But the problem here is, again, they're not watching their back, and we can see Mazen pushing from behind here.
Yeah, well, it's evidently going to be a B take, and we can see now the push comes in, but because Mazen pushed through a main, he was easily able to spot
the information.
Yeah, he got
and he let the rest of his teammates know, so
it's
they
as
adapted.
Simple as that. I mean, any team could put that together. Mm. Pushing through A main, getting the information, and saying, guys, there's absolutely nobody here. Unless they've got control of mid, which they hadn't, because there were a couple of players on the TT side who had control of mid, who had smoked out that T main area, they knew, well, it's evidently they're going to be heading towards B. So be on your guard and get ready for it. That's exactly what they did. They cleaned house, and now it's 9-1.
9-1. Is it going to be 9-2? Or is it going to be 10-1? Flipping so far. He's enjoyed these anti-eco rounds. Cryptics is going to shut down his small minute of fame, though, with the Tech 9. But Musambani wants to get revenge, and get revenge he will. 10-1 in favour of Existence.
Musambani, 17 frags, 5 assists, 2 deaths. That's all I'm going to say. Round number 12 it is, ladies and gentlemen. Existence now on double figures, 6 rounds away from victory here. And no, Kyanite, we've still got a long way to go. And we know that FM Esports have got a strong CT side, but so far in this entire final that we've been casting on the Esports stage, FM have only been able to pick up 3 rounds on their T side of both maps so far. I know we've still got a while to go, but that's just not good enough.
Well, it looks like they may not pick it up again here either. Is it going to be 11-1? Surely not. FM need to wake up and smell the bacon, because so far, Existence, I hate to say it, but they've looked like they're on a different level.
They are. They are at this rate. It really is a shame to say, because we really wanted a close grand final.
And Inferno was so close as well.
Yeah, it was.
It's a shame
if
this ends up being a one-sided second map.
Yeah, it will be. We're ready to go. We want more maps. I'm sure everybody at home does as well, because we love Counter-Strike, and we've had such a great tournament here. It's been an absolute pleasure to cast, and it would be a shame to see a complete shutout, but Mazen pushing aggressively down towards A main again, and Mike S misses his shot, and he will be punished for it.
Whoa, it sounds like Existence enjoyed that one. 5-2 now. Flipping all eyes on the B bomb site. Bomb on the back of Mr. Brandon Weber. And with 30 seconds to go, Chewy, they still have time to spearhead an attack towards this A-bomb site, but they've got to act fast, and they've got to pray to God that they get an entry here ASAP to at least plant this bomb down. Because look, they can't run through because of this goddamn Molotov. Existence are playing the clock down superbly.
Well, Weber will fall, as will Neil Genie. He gets a parting kill onto Mazen, but it's not going to be enough. One frag in the entirety of that round, and the clock ticked down right till the end, and we can see the FM Esports heads dropping now. It seems quiet. They sounded loud yesterday when they were playing up against Kick, when the momentum was in their favour, but it's not in their favour whatsoever here at all. Having a look at the scoreboard, we can just see, look at those blue heads in the middle of the screen. Look at how many rounds in a row Existence have won.
Wow, great opening frag from Cryptix, and hopefully, fingers crossed, this is a sign of things to come from FM. Musambani, they know he's there, but it's going to be tough here. The AKs need to get to work, but that Molotov going down, great secondary kill coming out from Cryptix, but Lowell has rotated through mid, and he's currently in vents. Molly goes down, 4-3. It's still advantage in favor of FM, but they might want to fall back here and regroup, but they're being flanked from behind.
Mazen once again on the flank, will find two kills. They need to shut this player down. He gets three, and he's going to get the fourth. He will, 4K from Mazen to completely shut down FM and Kyanite. I'm sorry, I know we've got a couple more rounds left in the bank here, but for me, that's almost goodnight, FM. I hate to say that, but they can't allow that to happen. They cannot.
Look, never say never. Existence were 12-3 down after the first half on Inferno, and we both know how that ended. So don't count FM Esports out this one. We both know how Inferno ended for them against Zenex yesterday. But that's not a good start for them. They've force bought here. They've got a Galil, Kalashnikov, two Rek9s to work with, and again, they've got to make sure they don't let Mazen flank them from behind. And you know what, Cryptix, I think he spotted him, but Mazen, is he going to win that battle? No, he won't. The aim master for FM Esports, getting that frag, evening things out at 4-on-4, and let's see where FM are going to go from here.
Lowell, a second, just looking in mid, he's going to see that Short has been smoked off, so he makes his way up on top of the balcony, finds a player there, and that Sokken easily dealt with. He gets a kill onto Cryptix, and now once again the man advantage goes in favor of Existence. He turns around and finds Mike S, and despite Cryptix starting to open things up over towards A, getting that kill onto Mazen, the rest of Mason's squad able to do damage, and now Neil Zinio's hiding in vents with a Galil. They know exactly where he is. He'll miss his shot, he'll get punished for it. And the Spanish move within three rounds of becoming your I-54 champions.
They do indeed. And you have to wonder for FM Esports. It almost seems like they've tried everything.
Yeah.
And they just can't crack it here on Cash, which is a bit strange, since Cash is actually quite a popular map in the UK. But obviously, I'm going to assume that Inferno is most likely FM's pick, because it's been their first pick throughout this entire thing. But here we go, Rek9 rush straight into the A-bomb site. Neil, he's dealt a heck of a load of damage onto the Spaniard, hiding at quad, but Lowell and Kyrie are sweeping them up at the moment, and Mike S now in a 1-3. It's easier said than done. He knows that they're all around him, and that's the start, and hopefully a start of many for the Dutchman. Lowell dealing damage to Mike S through the smoke, and unfortunately, as far as that half is concerned, the Fat Lady sung 14-1, and if Existence win their pistol here, I'm not sure if I can see a way back into the game for FM Esports. No.
Once again, you know, we've got to point out that this is a shame for FM, because they've been so great this tournament. They've fought hard in every single game. Again, I know I've been mentioning it a lot, but
honestly,
in the games that they've
had, the fact that they beat Kick in two BO3s by itself and fought incredibly well against Existence on Inferno means they deserve a huge pat on the back. And they've shown that
definitely.
The UK does have teams capable of competing against teams at this level.
I completely agree. I couldn't argue against that. And those games against Kick were so close. Two of them going to overtime. One of them was a 16-14 result as well. So, you know, they can do damage. But Mike S with a nice shot onto Musambani there. That was a lovely way to start things off. Let's see if that's the start of more to come here. As flipping responds there onto Sokken. It's left on a 4-4.
Yeah, 4 versus 4. Crucial frag there coming out for Existence to level things up. But again, FM looking to apply the pressure nice and fast here. But there's the opening onto the B bomb site. They've got one more player to try and deal with. But it's Cryptix who's dealing with the Spaniards at the moment. He will make it 3. And Flippin's probably saying to himself right now, Flippin, heck, I've got a 3 versus 1 on the cards. And let's see if he can pull it out of the bag. And you know what? He can't. Perfect USP work from both Cryptix and Mike S there.
Khan, I'm disappointed in you because that's the first time you've tried to make a joke out of one of the players' names yet so far in this series. Usually you're on top of it right from the start of map one, but this time you're a tiny bit late. But still,
yeah,
a good
one.
Weird
Spanish names.
Is it? Is that
I think Masambani is a sick name, though.
It is quite
no
cool.
No idea what it the means. I'm sure it has some meaning in Spanish.
The way it just rolls off the tongue as a caster is pretty cool. I like mine. But anyway, 14-2, is this the start of one phenomenal comeback from FM?
Well, they did it against Zenix yesterday. See if they can do it again here up against the Spaniards. Molly going out. Neil pairs with that MP9. Socken in and around the same area as well with the UMP. Spraying a frame through the smoke, but no, the Tech-9s, the Rec-9s, as many call them. Chewy has his head in his hands, and apparently they nerfed it. I don't think they did.
Volvo, why you do this?
But don't rule FM out just yet.
No, don't rule FM.
They're the ones with the rifles.
14-2 it is, still as the bomb's been planted and the clock is ticking here. Going to switch that FAMAS out for the M4, but he's got to reload it. And still just going to mean the clock is ticking. And it's just not going to work here. The Tech-9's reign supreme. And despite the nerf in inverted commas, Existence move themselves onto match point. And I'm not going to moan too much about the Tech-9's because Valve's been on our side today, Kai Knight, after we unboxed a knife earlier on this afternoon. So I'm not going to worry too much about the Tech-9 and moan too much because it's all I seem to do as a caster nowadays.
It's, you know, casually showing off to everyone.
Oh, come on.
That you
it was a good
unboxed
one.
Tonight. And here we go. No room for error whatsoever now for FM Esports. They lose this round, they lose the best of 5, and they'll be going home. Good start from Socken, but the frag has been returned, and this does favour the T's, not just because they're the ones with the rifles, but because it means the CT's can cover much less ground. And Existence, it looks like they're heading towards the B bomb site. Weber, with this Desert Eagle, has a heck of a load of work to do. And is that going to be the start of many? As the Spaniards try to pick up this bomb.
Oh, nice shot from Masambani there, and that means that he's the last one left alive versus 2. Nildinho has been able to pick up a FAMAS, well, Galil even, sorry, I apologise. But with 50 seconds left on the clock, he's going to find the head of that player, but he won't be able to quite pick up the kill.
He heard Nildinho creeping from behind him. It's Neil with the Galil up against Masambani, and Cryptix. Good force buy round there from FM Esports.
I mean, Kyanite, they've got no room for error. It's a great round, and credit to FM for that, but I think it's too little too late, in all honesty.
Never say never. Existence now. In order for them to win this one, they're the ones who are going to have to force buy FM Esports. So Socken with the scout at mid. Weber with the Galil, which he, of course, picked up in the last round. Mike S with the newly buffed MP9. Both Neil and Cryptix with rifles as well. So nades are plenty at the moment for FM Esports, but that's a great start for Kyrie. With the Desert Eagle, Mike S hits the ground, and Neil knows what's coming here. He knows as the smoke's rained down onto this A-bomb site that it most likely will be a plow onto this site. And let's see, Cryptix has joined in to try and help him out, but you know what? The bomb's gone all the way to B.
Oh dear, not exactly what they would have wanted, FM whatsoever, so they've got to get their running shoes on and make their way over there quickly. It's 2 kills in favour of Existence. Will this be the last time that we see around here at Counter-Strike? It will be indeed. Mason finishes off 2. Existence are your G2A.com Counter-Strike Global Offensive Champions. What a game from them. Very well played. Kyanite, they did not drop a single map at this event.
No, but let's be honest, did we expect otherwise? It's no lie that Existence, despite obviously being seeded second, which in my opinion was a mistake, Existence at this current event are the strongest team.
Yeah.
But again, FM, they've got a lot of positives to look at. A lot of people thought that they were just going to be another UK team and we were going to have a kick Existence final, but they proved not just everyone here wrong, but the Counter-Strike community wrong as well. They proved that the UK, we do have a team capable of competing at this level of Counter-Strike. Yeah. And I loved the fact that they beat kick in a second BO3 as well, because it proved that the first one wasn't just a fluke.
Yeah, yeah. And again, that first best of three that we saw on the esports stage yesterday evening was a very close one. So it wouldn't surprise me if people thought, oh, it's some sort of fluke because the games were so close. And even though the games were close earlier on today, credit to FM because they did do a lot of damage. Credit to them for being able to push themselves through to the grand final. They've had a heck of a long tournament, as has everybody here. I'm pretty sure that Existence is one of the teams who's played the least amount of maps just because they've been dominating everybody here. They've gone right the way through the upper bracket into the grand final.
Also need to bear in mind that at this event, Sokken has been a stand-in, despite the fact that he's played so well. Windansky is actually FM Esports' main fifth. So, you know, things may have ended differently if FM were playing with their full proper lineup. Yeah. But again, for them to beat Kick with even a stand-in, things are looking good for FM Esports right now.
Yeah, they've got to stick together, they've got to keep working, and I think they'll be able to challenge back at I-55 very soon indeed. So, Kyanite, I have one more question for you, good sir. MVP.
MVP for me. Oh, I don't know, it's a tough one. I think, I forgot his name.
You've forgotten the name. Well, I'm Mason, going for Mason. Mason. That's who Mason, I was going for. So we are finally in a grill for the first time, it seems like, in forever.
We're not good with Spanish names.
No, we're not. No. But me and Kyanite are going to agree that I think we're going to give our MVP award away to Mason, especially in that last series. He was darn phenomenal. But credit to all of the Existence lineup coming into this tournament, traveling from Spain, doing some good damage. We hope that we can see them back for I-55. We hope that we have another good tournament in I-55 in a couple of months' time. But anyway, guys, I think we are ready to give the checks out on the stage in a few minutes' time. Hopefully we will be. Anyway, guys, I think we're going to end it there. Kyanite, any parting words, good sir?
Nope. Thank you for everyone who tuned in. Let's go over to the stage.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it was a great series, and I have to say, I agree with the audience. MVP Alan. And for now, though, it is time to give out our checks. So, ladies and gentlemen, if they can make their way up to the stage to receive their check, our second place team in the G2A.com CSGO Challenge, it is FM Esports! Grab your check and look at the camera. When it gives you the thumbs up, you're good? You good? Right. One more time for FM! And, ladies and gentlemen, the new champions of Insomnia 54 make your way to the stage. It is Existence! Right. Grab the check, look at the camera.